Bunbury's Past. The Noongar Aboriginal tribes were the original inhabitants, benefiting from the fresh waters and fertile soils of the region. Early settlers chose Bunbury as a place to live at the mouth of the Preston and Collie rivers on a harbour known as Koombanah Bay. The town was founded by Lieutenant Henry Bunbury. Settlers arrived from 1839 onward, and by 1870 there were 300. Bunbury became the centre for a timber industry, sandalwood, production of horses, and farming produce. A large jetty, a quarter mile in distance, was constructed. By the 1890s, Bunbury had achieved the infrastructure as a transport hub. A railway from Boyanup was opened in 1891 to transport timber. The rail connection to Perth was made in 1893. Timber mills and yards were opened near the jetty. Work started on a breakwater in 1897. Coal from nearby Collie was transported through Bunbury. By 1900, the business district and settlers' houses were looking prosperous indeed. Bunbury was the principal port of the southern district, with a large bank, money order, telegraph service, savings bank, four churches, and two schools, including Bunbury High School. There was a court, jail, and steam-powered flour mill. A wooden lighthouse showing a light for a distance of 12 miles was erected in 1870. Population had reached 3,000 people with regular visits by steamers. During the First World War, a substantial dairy industry was established with a butter factory in Bunbury. Bunbury's role as a wheat terminal was strengthened in 1937 by the construction of a large silo near the port, ironically on the eve of a world slump in wheat prices. Fortunately, timber prices moved upwards, and the loss of overseas supplies with the outbreak of the Second World War stimulated demand for West Australian timber. There was, however, very little local manufacture, and tourism became a major industry with visitors from the goldfields. There were many activities, boating, surfing, and fishing, and a variety of organized sports, tennis courts, golf courses, croquet, and bowling greens. In 1950, the town boasted of 7 hotels, 3 hostels, and about 20 guest houses, which offered a wide variety of accommodation. Black Beach became the best known attraction, with a bathing pavilion and many other conveniences. With the popular use of motor cars, Bunbury became the center of a number of all-year weather roads, with scenic and historic drives radiating from the town. Industrialization of Bunbury began in the 1950s, including the mining of mineral sands, the opening of a chemical plant, bulk fuel storage tanks, and an enlarged concrete silo. Tensions developed between industrial development and environmental preservations, reaching a head by 1970. By 1991, the population had reached 25,000, and today it's 50,000, the second largest city in the state. Bunbury now has over 800 ships visit annually, coming for a A look at the modern Bunbury Harbour. The Bunbury Lighthouse still guides ships into the harbour safely, avoiding the treacherous coastline. There's substantial ocean traffic into Bunbury Harbour. 13 million tons of cargo in the last year. The harbour is serviced by both highways and the government railway. An aerial view of the harbour shows both the inner and the outer harbour, and the old government wharf extending towards the sea. There's substantial recreational activities in the harbour, including a large yacht club and frequent sailboats. The harbour, however, is primarily industrially oriented, with the large woodchip industry, wheat exporting industry, and mineral sands industry. These silos are for shipping wheat, I believe. Freight trains bring both wheat and bauxite to the harbour. These old wheat silos are no longer used. The Port of Busselton was in competition with Bunbury until it shut in 1972. Titanium mineral sands are mined locally and shipped out. The Bunbury Power Station, the old and the modern. The harbour today is undergoing substantial development with a multi-million dollar plan for expansion. It will include a component to expand tourism with the lovely sand beaches.